you are from Tobago.
Yes,
originally.
Yes, yes.
And then you moved to Brooklyn?
Yes.
Tell me, what was Tobago like?
Oh, I grew up on the beach. So our house was, there was the house. You walked maybe 10
steps. It's also known as your retirement plan.
My retirement plan, yeah.
We just have this really great mix of people down there. Beautiful, wonderful food. Grew up hearing a lot of folklore stories. You know, things like that. So I got into storytelling really early.
Yeah. And
I'm just thinking, many actors would tell the story of acting to try and get to where you started.
Yeah.
What gave you the acting bug to leave that life and start doing what you're doing now?
Well, like I said, I grew up around storytellers. Everything in Trinidad is a story. Yeah. Right. You know what I mean? A guy goes to get ice cream. He's like, you know, this man, yeah? Yeah, give me one scoop in him. This man, give me two scoops, or three scoops. And you're like, okay, so you got three scoops of ice cream. And everything is this big epic. So I grew up around just the culture of people like that. And then moving here, you know, being an immigrant, I became a little bit reclusive.
Yeah.
So I started watching a lot of TV, things like that. And one of the first things that I watched, one of these, you know, sitcoms was Frasier.
Oh, yeah.
So back in the day. And one of the episodes was with Derek Jacobi. Do you remember Derek Jacobi,
yeah.
This Shakespearean guy?
Yeah.
So he was doing a really bad Hamlet.
Yeah.
And Frasier and Niles remembered it as one of the best performances they ever had, and they built it up the entire episode. And then when they saw it again, it was just terrible.
Terrible. Right.
So he's like, I die, Horatio, I die. And you have this like crazy scene. So I ran around the house for like weeks just performing this bad Hamlet. You know what I mean? And that was like the first thing, you know.
And is that what led you to Yale
led
Drama School?
Led me to high school.
To high school.
Yes.
Then to Yale. And now.